Hello, good evening. Welcome. 6 p.m. Prime coming to you live from the National Capital this evening once again. And today, ladies and gentlemen, on the occasion of the Lohri, farmers have decided to escalate their protest. Neither the Supreme Court staying the bills nor the committee has been able to give the confidence to the farmers that there is some resolution in sight. As you see, the farmers sitting behind me, as the entire day today, Lohri celebrations were marked overwhelmingly. The theme was not only in Punjab, but also on the borders of the national capital. Farm protest dominated the Lohri celebrations this year. The farmers in for a long haul, ready for the battle ahead, despite the intervention of the Supreme Court. I'm Ankit Tyagi. Let's very quickly start with our top story. We will be, in fact, focusing and taking you through to all the borders and also to Punjab, where the Lohri celebrations today have been taking place. Now, days ahead of round 10 of the talks between the farmers and the government. Remember, the next round of talks is scheduled for Friday, the 15th of January. The farmers, in a big signal to the centre amid Lohri festivities, burnt the copies of the three farm bills, marking their dissatisfaction over the laws. Burning of the farm bills took place at Singhu, Tikri and Ghazipur border, along with various places of Punjab.
लाया जाता है, अच्छाई की कसम ली जाती है। लोहड़ी में हमने तीन कानून की प्रतियां जलाई हैं। ये जला के हमने सरकार को ये सिग्नल दिया है कि इसी तरह ये बिल जो है, एक दिन हमारे गुस्से की भेंट चढ़ेंगे और सरकार को इनको वापस लेने चाहिए।
5 o'clock was the time when the farmers wanted to give, in fact, given for their protest, their indicative protest on the day of Lohri. A full escalation ladder has been planned by the farmers, which is leading up to 26 January. Let's just take a look at this report, which has been filed by my colleagues from the Singhu border, where the bill burning started at 5 p.m.
At the Singhu border, the Lohri festival is being celebrated in a different way. The farmers here have resolved that they will not budge from Singhu, even as the Supreme Court has intervened. And it's a big festival for them, these farmers who gathered around this bonfire. And instead of the usual traditional popcorns and other sweets that they do actually throw into this bonfire, they have burnt the laws, saying that these are the black laws that we are against. You can see that this is just a small pocket, but across the Singhu border, there have been these small bonfires everywhere where farmers have resolved that they will not budge from the Singhu border. A big festival in Punjab and Haryana, the Lohri festival that welcomes the summer and says goodbye to the winters. It's a harvest season for the farmers, but nothing has stopped these farmers from agitating and saying what they want to say with a great resolve. So a show of solidarity is what you see. Farmers gathered around this bonfire with flags, and each and everyone taking turns to speak and express that though it's a big festival of celebration, this is the way that they will celebrate this festival in this hour of crisis for the farmers community. With video journalist Sanjay, this is Mosmi Singh in Delhi for India Today.
For a quick live update, let me now take you to my colleagues, Mosmi Singh, who is joining us from the Singhu border. Abhishek Anand is at the Ghazipur border. We also have Satendra Chauhan, who is joining us from Chandigarh, because this time, Festival of Lohri, the Festival of Harvest, is with a note of rebellion. Coming to you first, Mosmi, give us a sense of how the Festival of Lohri has only been now another chapter which has added in the spirits and determination of the farmers against this farm law. What are you witnessing around you?
Ankit, at the Singhu border, the farmers are saying, Mungfuli di khushbu te gur di mithas. मुबारक होवे तनू लोहड़ी का त्योहार बट दिस त्योहार दिस फेस्टिवल इज ऑफ अ डिफरेंट नेचर टुडे बिकॉज यू कैन सी इंस्टेड ऑफ बीइंग एट होम विद देयर फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली द फार्मर्स हियर सर्कल अराउंड दिस बॉनफायर सेलिब्रेटिंग लोहड़ी विद अ रिजॉल्व that they will unless their mission is accomplished they are not going anywhere youngsters you can see children you can see women right here at the Singhu border and as they burn copies of the law they are very clear that no matter how many days it takes the fight here is going to continue a show of solidarity you can see farmers here getting peanuts and ravdis putting them on fire along with the historic law that has caused a clash between the farmers and the government a little girl here I'll ask her aap yahan pe kyun aaye hain kahan se aaye
ludhiana se
ludhiana jila
kya kehna chahte hain
ji
hazur khan ekta zindabad
hazur khan ekta zindabad
आज लोहड़ी का त्योहार है घर की याद नहीं आ रही है आप लोगों को सारे युवा हैं यहाँ पे क्या कहना चाहते हैं माँ को क्या कहना चाहते हैं घर पे
यही कहना चाहते हैं कि हम यहाँ सभी एक परिवार की तरह रहते हैं सभी एक परिवार की तरह रहते हैं और हमने यहाँ पर लोहड़ी के त्योहार के दिन दुल्हापट्टी का इतिहास दोहराते हुए हमने यहाँ पे इस लोहड़ी में मूंगफली रेवड़ी के साथ साथ सरकार के द्वारा हम पे थोपे जा रहे बिलों को भी फाड़ दिया है जला दिया है
दैट्स द डिफरेंस हियर यू नो यंगस्टर्स टू एल्डरली मेन एवरीबॉडी वुमेन एंड चिल्ड्रन राइट हियर दिस पिक्चर दैट यू सीइंग एन एरियल शॉट ऑफ व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन एट द सिंघू बॉर्डर अ क्लियर मैसेज फ्रॉम द फार्मर्स हियर अंकित ओवर टू यू
ओके Right, so in fact, Moshmi Singh there from the Singhu border. Let me now take you to Abhishek Anand, who is at the Ghazipur border. Abhishek, you heard all those people, including that little girl who was in fact speaking about the unity. Lohri this time has been of a very, very different flavor. What is it that you are witnessing at the Ghazipur border?
Well, certainly, Ankit, Lohri is being celebrated here. It is started with the burning of the copies of the new farm bills. You can see a number of farmers gathered here. They have lit a bonfire and they are sitting around. And the Lohri celebrations is quite peaceful this time here. We have some farmer leaders here. Sir, kya naam hai aapka aur kaise Lohri celebrate kar rahe hain aap log yahan?
Rajbir Singh Jadon, Pradesh Adhyaksh, Bharatiya Kisan Union, Uttar Pradesh.
सर लोहड़ी के दिन आप लोग इस तरीके से यहाँ पर बैठे हैं घर कैसे इसको कर रहे हैं घर नहीं जाना है वहाँ पे कैसे चलेंगे
अब तो यही घर है दो महीने से यहाँ पर हैं और अगले कई दिनों महीनों तक यहाँ रहना है तो अब यही घर है यहीं पर लोहड़ी मनाएंगे यहीं पर मकर संक्रांति मनाएंगे तो सारा त्यौहार यहीं मनाया जा रहा है
आप बताइए साहब आप कहाँ से आए हैं
हम आए जी सितारगंज उधम सिंह नगर से
उधम सिंह नगर से इतनी दूर आए हैं साहब लोहड़ी यहीं पर मन रही है और कितने त्यौहार मनाने का
जब तक मोदी सरकार नहीं मानेगी सब तैयार यहीं मनाए जाएंगे रात दिन यहीं बैठे रहेंगे
कैसे लोहड़ी मन रही है साहब कितने लोग हैं क्या सेलिब्रेशन जैसे आप लोग घर पे तो धूमधाम से करते हैं यहाँ कैसे कर रहे हैं
देखो घर वाला पूरा माहौल तो नहीं बना हुआ है लेकिन फिर भी माहौल को देखते हुए बहुत बढ़िया माहौल बना हुआ है हम किसानों का बहुत एकता से लोहड़ी मना रहे हैं पूरा सेलिब्रेट कर रहे हैं जी
So these are the farmers from different areas, from different, from Uttar Pradesh, from Uttarakhand, from Punjab, and all these have gathered together to celebrate Lohri, and it's quite peaceful here as compared to the Singhu border. There are people, there are such bonfires at certain stretches of this Ghazipur border. This is a 1 kilometer long stretch, and the farmers are now distributing peanuts and ravdis, and this is how the celebration of Lohri is going on and they have actually marked their protest at the starting of
okay.
the celebration okay. of the Lohri by burning the copies over to you Ankit
right thank you Abhishek it's just not the borders where the farmers are right now even in Punjab this time the fervor the mood and the flavor of the celebration of Lohri is all written on the farmers protest let me take you to Chandigarh where my colleague Satendra Chauhan is joining us right now Satendra we've seen at the borders the farmers burning the copies of the bill. What is the situation in Punjab? Because the protest so far has only been able to sustain itself till now because of the support that they are getting back home in their villages and from their families.
Ankit, there is the same situation in Punjab also. You can see visuals first. There are many people here and they are celebrating this Lohri. They have gajak, mungfali, rebdi, but kale kanun. ये पंजाबी में लिखा हुआ है, पूरी फाइल बनाई हुई है यहाँ पर, और ये लोग यहाँ पर लोहड़ी के साथ साथ कहीं ना कहीं एक विरोध प्रदर्शन भी कर रहे हैं। आज लोहड़ी का त्योहार है, लेकिन आप ये फाइल लेकर क्यों खड़े हुए हैं?
ये काला कानून है, क्योंकि लोहड़ी हमारा बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण त्योहार है, पर हमारे जो किसान भाई हैं वो वहां पे बैठे हैं, हमारा दिल नहीं करता मनाने को, पर अब हमने सोचा भी इसकी मोदी को काले कानूनों को अकेला अकेला बरका कर यहाँ आग लगाकर हमारे, क्योंकि 70 से ज्यादा जो किसान है वहाँ शहीद हो चुके हैं, इस सरकार पे कोई सुनवाई नहीं है, सारा कुछ इन्हों का मिली भुगत से आते हैं जाते हैं, जबकि ये 10 मिनट का काम है, जैसे 10 मिनट में इन्होंने कानून पास कराए हैं वैसे ये इसे रद्द भी कर सकते हैं, अगर किसान नहीं चाहते ये क्यों दे रहे हैं किसानों को? इसलिए आज हमें यहाँ पे पंजाब में हमारे गाँव के जो है हलालपुर गांव, उसमें आज इनके काले
अंकित ये तस्वीरें आप देखिए, यहाँ पर किस तरीके से लोहड़ी सेलिब्रेशन हो रहा है, गांव का चबूतरा है, पेड़ है, ट्रैक्टर यहाँ पर खड़े हुए हैं, तमाम किसान हैं और किसान यूनियन के झंडे इनके हाथों में हैं, और लोहड़ी का जो सेलिब्रेशन होता है ये कहीं ना कहीं मौसम का सेलिब्रेशन होता है, सर्दी को विदाई दी जाती है, आग जलाई जाती है, इस आग में तिल डाले जाते हैं, लेकिन यहाँ पर अब की बार ये रंग बदला हुआ है, यहाँ पर नारेबाजी हो रही है, कानून की प्रतियां जलाई जा रही हैं, तो कुल मिलाकर जो लोहड़ी का सेलिब्रेशन जो दिल्ली बॉर्डर पर आप दिखा रहे थे, वही सिचुएशन कहीं ना कहीं पंजाब में बनी हुई है, और पंजाब के जो लोग हैं वो भी उसी तरीके से लोहड़ी मना रहे हैं जिस तरीके से दिल्ली बॉर्डर पर किसान मना रहे हैं। अंकित,
द फेस्टिवल ऑफ हार्वेस्ट, थैंक यू सतेंद्र फॉर गिविंग अस दैट कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव अपडेट, द फेस्टिवल ऑफ हार्वेस्ट, द फेस्टिवल विच मार्क्स द बिगिनिंग और विच मार्क्स द एंड एटलीस्ट यू नो फॉर अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल ऑफ द ऑफ विंटर्स बिगिनिंग ऑफ द अर्ली स्टेप्स ट्रेसेस ऑफ स्प्रिंग, बट द फैक्ट इज लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन दिस टाइम नथिंग चेंजेस फॉर द फार्मर्स दोज हु आर इन फॉर वॉट दे बिलीव अ फाइट टू finish as far as this entire battle against the farm laws is concerned. Now, as the songs of protest are reverberating on the borders of the national capital, the traditional songs during Lohri, the traditional songs which are sung during Lohri, have also now have a tinge of protest. The farmers' protest is the dominating theme even in the traditional songs which are sung during the festival of Lohri. Take a look at this story.
Antique re-protest encampments. Supporters of the agitation sing praises of protesting farmers digging in along Delhi's borders with patience. The poetics slam the contentious laws, their authors, and call for consigning the legislation to the flames. Rooted in folklore, the Singhu Tikri Lohri song is one in a series of anthems that have swept Punjab and the Punjabi diaspora overseas from the start of the ongoing agitation. With Manjeet Sehgal, Bureau Report, India Today.
Be Ranik, at the border where I am standing at the Chilla border. In fact, celebrations of Lohri also taking place here. Gajaks and ravaries are being distributed among all the farmers, those who have been protesting here. But the fact is, ladies and gentlemen, all these farmers, whether they are in small groups, bigger groups, you know, you can see them here as well. Everybody who is coming in with determination. All of them, in fact, hoping, talking about only one fact, that the farm laws need to go, and they will continue their protest till the time that happens. Whether it's Lohri or it goes on to Baisakhi, all the festivals possibly would be celebrated in protest if, according to the farmers, these laws are not taken back. Now, apart from this, a big controversy, we spoke about this yesterday as well, has erupted over the four members of the Supreme Court appointed panel. The farmers are unhappy, and they believe that this is once again showing, you know, that the mistrust, the government, the Supreme Court has not appointed the people, those who have an open mind when it comes to, in fact, discussing these farm laws. And that is one reason why the farmers have rejected the committee formed by the Supreme Court. The farmers fear that the union, the panel which has been formed, are supporters of the very laws they are protesting against. Now, just take a look. Agro-scientist Pramod Kumar Joshi, he had openly hailed the laws, saying the laws give more options to the farmers. Bharatiya Kisan Union President Bhupinder Singh Mann, who is also the member of this panel, had called the implementation for the farm laws. Agricultural economist Ashok Gulati had compared these new laws to de-licensing of the industry in 1991. And Maharashtra-based Union Shetkari Sangathan Chief Anil Ganawat had said that if these laws would be repealed, no one would dare to bring any reforms. So the farmers say that these are the people, those who have already made up their mind in favor of these laws. What's the point of going and contesting or arguing with them?
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने एक आज फैसला किया है जो हमें मीडिया के जरिए ही पता चला है. अभी तक उसकी कॉपी या उसके बारे में डिटेल्स हमें नहीं मिली है, लेकिन जैसे डॉक्टर दर्शनपाल जी ने कहा कि हम समझते हैं कि सरकार की ये शरारत है कि वो अपने ऊपर से ये प्रेशर कम करने के लिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जरिए ये कमेटी वगैरह ले आई, जिसका हमने कल ही विरोध कर दिया था कि हम ऐसी कमेटी के सामने पेश नहीं होंगे. हमारा आंदोलन एज इट इज सरकार के साथ चलता रहेगा.
दी कमेटी हैज बीन फॉर्म्ड विथ प्रो कॉर्पोरेट पीपल. ऑल प्रो कॉर्पोरेट पीपल आर देयर. दे आर एंटी फार्मर्स पीपल. दे विल गिव अ जजमेंट इन फेवर ऑफ द एक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू गवर्नमेंट एडवाइस एंड सुप्रीम कोर्ट विल से इट इज अ कमेटी एट रूल. इट इज लॉजिकल कंक्लूजन विल बी देयर. The crores and crores poor farmers will be sacrificed at the altar of this black act.
Supreme Court से बहुत उम्मीद पूरे देश को है और थी, परंतु Supreme Court ने भी जो चारों सदस्य कमेटी के बनाए, वो तो पहले ही मोदी जी के कानूनों के समर्थक हैं, वो तो इन काले कानूनों के पक्षधर हैं. ऐसी कमेटी के सदस्य क्या न्याय करेंगे? परंतु प्रधानमंत्री जी, इतने अहंकारी मत बनिए, यह अहंकार टूटेगा जरूर. किसानों की अन्नदाता की सुनिए, वरना यह देश आपकी बात सुनना बंद कर देगा.
I'm now being joined by National Affairs Editor India Today, Rahul Srivastav. We are also being joined by Master Shivraj Singh, President of the Bharatiya Kisan Union, Aparajita Sarangi, National Spokesperson, Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha, Bharatiya Janata Party is also joining us on the broadcast. I welcome you all on the 6 p.m. prime. Rahul, I just want to start with you. There was already suspicion as far as the farmers are concerned in the ongoing talks between the government and the farmers on the intention of the government of India. Now, with the Supreme Court mandated committee, the kind of views that this panel has only increased the mistrust of the farmers.
Ankit, without standing on judgment about what the Supreme Court has done, what I will say that the breakdown or the failure of farmer unions and the government to arrive on a point of convergence as far as the contentious three laws are concerned, eventually created a situation where the courts, the issue was taken to the courts. The government found that that's the most suitable option for it to create a face-saving exit. And it took it to the Supreme Court, and eventually, despite a reprimand, remember, there has been a small triumph for the farmers that the bills have been on an interim put on hold. But beyond that, yes, what one can say is that though Makar Sankranti, Lohri and all mark the a day which is depicted by the solar cycle, not the lunar, there is virtually no thawing. And I think the freeze is on. Eventually, if you see what happened now, that on the 15th, when the government meets, what are the options that do the farmers have? The government will say, we are ready to amend as per your demands, say 9 amendments which you have suggested, or you go to the Supreme Court appointed committee. Now, the farmers had doubts about the committee, but that's what the Supreme Court has done. That's the apex court. That decision is coming from a court beyond which there is no court of appeal. Now, the farmers will have to really think about it, how they are going to go ahead. And that's why their options, perhaps, but the government, by going to the Supreme Court, has narrowed the options for the farmers, and eventually their bargaining power could well go down. I think what the farmers are doing smartly is by Lohri celebrating, burning the laws and all. They're keeping the enthusiasm going. They're keeping the spirit of the protest going.
Rahul, may I request you to stay on with me? I want to go across to Master Shivraj Singh. Master Shivraj Singh, now, what are the options for the farmers? 15th, you go in front of the government. You again have another round of the talks. And as Rahul was saying, it will be easy for the government to say, why don't you go to the panel which has been formed by the Supreme Court? If the farmers don't believe in the laws made by the parliament, if they don't even believe in the panel formed by the Supreme Court, the message possibly would go across that the farmers are now playing hardball.
नहीं, मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा, माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने जो कमेटी बनाई है वो पहले ही सक्के धारे में है, क्योंकि वो पहले ही इस काले कानून का सपोर्ट कर चुकी है। जो पंच है, अगर वो पक्ष बन जाएंगे तो ऐसे पंच पर संदेह होता है। तो हमारे जो सीनियर एडवोकेट है एपी सिंह, जो बीके लोक शक्ति की तरफ से अपियर हुए थे माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट में, उनसे हम इस कमेटी पर आपत्ति दर्ज कराएंगे, और अभी एक दो दिन में वो अपने तैयार कर रहे हैं। ये जो कमेटी सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने बताई है, इसके प्रति हम आपत्ति दर्ज कराएंगे सुप्रीम कोर्ट में। मैं ऐसी कमेटी के सामने नहीं जाएंगे जो पहले ही कमेटी बनने से पहले ही इस तीनों अध्यादेशों का सपोर्ट कर चुका है।
जी, मैं यू नो आई वुड हैव वांटेड टू कंटिन्यू दिस इन इंग्लिश, बट लेट मी जस्ट गो अक्रॉस टू अपराजिता सारंगी। अपराजिता जी, आपने सुना मास्टर स्वराज क्या कह रहे हैं, और सारे जो किसान नेता हैं, दे हैव बीन सेइंग ओनली वन थिंग, दे डोंट बिलीव इन द कमिटी। इन दैट सिचुएशन, व्हेन द फार्मर्स वॉन्ट टू कंटिन्यू टॉक्स विद द गवर्नमेंट, नाउ सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज ऑल्सो अ प्लेयर, द सेंस इज फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड फॉर द फार्मर्स दैट इट इज अ प्लॉय बींग डिप्लॉयड बाय द गवर्नमेंट टू मिनिमाइज देयर ऑप्शंस as far as the deliberations are concerned.
A very good evening. At the outset, let me say that this is a big day for the farmers of India. Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana completes its 5 years, and I congratulate all the 29 crore farmers who have immensely benefited from the implementation of this scheme over the last 5 years. Now, having said that, let me tell you that this apprehension of many of the farmers organizations regarding the members of the panel, regarding the credibility of the members of the panel, is absolutely baseless. And it is very easy to be unhappy about everything that is done. Now, is there any court, any appellate authority over and above Honorable Supreme Court? Now, here is an apex court which has issued an order, which has issued a judgment. And I think it's our responsibility, our duty to obey the orders of the Supreme Court. So I think I will make an appeal on behalf of the Bharatiya Janata Party to all the farmers' organizations to obey the orders of the Supreme Court, to have respect for the orders of the Supreme Court, to respect the judgment of the Supreme Court, and let's believe in the panel. That's it.
Ji. मास्टर शिवराज, अगर अगर सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जो पैनल बनाया गया है उसके सामने अगर किसान नहीं जाएंगे, तो आपके विरोधियों को तो ये कहने में आसानी होगी कि आप कानून की अवहेलना कर रहे हैं, आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट की अवहेलना कर रहे हैं।
नहीं, हम सुप्रीम कोर्ट की अवहेलना तो पहले सरकार भी कर चुकी है। जब एससी एसटी कानून पर सुप्रीम कोर्ट अपनी इन्होंने अपना आदेश सुनाया था तो उसके एससी एसटी के ऊपर अध्यादेश लेकर के सरकार आई थी। जब गन्ना किसानों के ऊपर सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कहा था 14 दिन के अंदर पेमेंट हो जाए, अगर 14 दिन से लेट अगर पेमेंट होती है तो ब्याज सहित भुगतान किया जाए, सरकार ने आज तक नहीं कराया। सरकार तो कई बार सुप्रीम कोर्ट के ऊपर आ चुकी है, सुप्रीम कोर्ट के आदेश को कई बार नकार चुकी है, एससी एसटी में उसके ऊपर अध्यादेश ले आई थी। तो हम तो माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट का पालन करते हैं, इसीलिए अपने वकील को खड़ा करके पहले सुप्रीम कोर्ट में जो कमेटी बनाई है 4 सदस्यीय, इसको आपत्ति दर्ज कराएंगे सुप्रीम कोर्ट में वकील को अपीयर करके, जो वरिष्ठ वकील है एपी सिंह उनके द्वारा। भारतीय किसान लोक शक्ति सुप्रीम कोर्ट जाएगी और इस कमेटी पे आपत्ति।
अपराजिता सारंगी जी, इन द इंटरेस्ट एंड बिफोर आई गेट इन राहुल एज वेल, इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ trying to find a resolution as far as this entire ongoing problem is concerned, because remember it's been 48 days that the farmers have been out in cold, can the government, because it was the government and certain other petitioners, those who had gone to the Supreme Court, not the farmers, those who are protesting on the borders of Delhi, should the government also not ask the Supreme Court maybe to include some other members in the panel, which could bring confidence as far as these talks are concerned? This is an opportunity after the embarrassment which the government faced of the laws being stayed for to find a resolution as far as this ongoing problem is concerned.
See, the entire nation has seen the attitude of the central government and the government of Prime Minister Modi. We have all been trying all through to have dialogues with the farmers' unions. We believe in discourse. We believe in debate. We believe in argument. But we believe talking across the table. 48 days have passed and we are very sorry to see the farmers sitting in this cold weather on the outskirts of Delhi. But I think the farmers' unions must come to the table, must think about the whole thing with some kind of flexibility. You know, if we are rigid, we will not be able to arrive at a solution. And I think all of us need a solution. Now, the Supreme Court, as a third party, has come into the picture. Supreme Court heard both the parties, the central government as well as the farmers' unions. And then the Supreme Court has given a very considered judgment. And I think we all should actually respect the judgment. Okay. And with all humility, we must accept this judgment.
Rahul,
and the matter
it
is,
was not the farmers, those anyway, who are protesting on the borders, who went to the Supreme Court. Who went to the Supreme Court, Rahul. And for the government, which possibly had a chance to avoid the embarrassment of a law which has been passed by the current government, by the parliament, being stayed by the Supreme Court without even, you know, giving a single hearing on the constitutionality of this law is concerned. Could the government have approached, you know, in a different way, possibly put the laws in abeyance themselves? That possibly could have built some confidence as far as the farmers is concerned. Right now, despite the Supreme Court coming in, we are looking at a situation where both the Supreme Court and the government's position seems to have little effect on the farmers, those who are protesting.
Ankit, I slightly disagree here, because I think if you look at it, the farmers' unions are also have a very radical demand. X and nothing else. I think on a negotiation table, radical stands are very difficult to negotiate. And remember, a government has much deeper pockets. And the government negotiated visibly, it created at least a visible pixel moment that it is negotiating. It might not have actually done nothing. It might have sat around in meetings and said that we will do this and nothing else. The fact remains that the government always has the option of going to the Supreme Court. And one panelist said that the third party Supreme Court, the Supreme Court is not a party, it's an adjudicator between parties. And the Supreme Court, in its wisdom, has ruled a committee. Now, in doing that, what it did, it reprimanded the government. The laws have been put on interim hold. Now, that's an olive branch to the farmers. It also said MSP will continue unabated as it was before the rules were passed. It also said that a farmer lands will not be impacted or seized during this period. It has set up a committee. I think the problem here is that the demands have become so rigid. Eventually, the farmers are so so lacking in trust vis-a-vis the government that all intentions are being doubted at a time today when the festival is all about the farmer and all that is put into the agni and fire is from the farms.
Okay. Aparajita, in conclusion, I just want you to, you know, to tell our viewers, what are the options for the governments? The farmers are unrelenting. They are not going to hold back. They are not going to go back. What are the options for the government when it now proceeds on 15th? Because 26th January is going to be a big test, both for the government and also for the farmers.
So we have tremendous regard for the farmers. We are with the farmers and we would continue to remain beside the farmers. One after the other, every day there is a welfare scheme for the farmers, and we are very proud of it, the way, you know, Prime Minister Modi has been showing his concern for the farmers. His government is with the farmers, I reiterate. Having said that, let me tell you that, as I said earlier, the entire nation knows how we have been handling this. We believe in discourse, and we have also told the farmers' unions that there would be amendments at about 7 to 9 places. We are ready for those amendments. We also are ready to give in writing as regards the MSP. Okay. MSP is continuing. Now, let me tell you, please give me 30 seconds. Last time, I remember 420 lakh metric tons of rice had been procured. Paddy had been procured. And this time, already we have procured 531 lakh metric tons of paddy in the mandis at the MSP. So what I'm trying to tell you is, and this is 26.32% more than what we did last year, as I gave you the figures. So there is absolutely no question in the intention of the government. Now, we have gone to the Supreme Court. There were 3 petitions which were heard, and Supreme Court has given some kind of judgment. And I think we all should accept this judgment with humility. And let's wait for the panel. We cannot distrust everybody.
So the government,
the farmers unions, with all our regard for them, they distrusted.
Government at least has now the option for 2 months to stand behind this panel, which has been given 2 months to, in fact, furnish its report. मास्टर शिवराज, अंत में मैं आपसे पूछना चाहूंगा, बार बार सरकार भी ये सवाल पूछ रही है कि अगर कुछ बातचीत होनी है, कुछ समझौता निकलना है, तो सरकार कहती है कि एक आध कदम तो आपको भी पीछे आना पड़ेगा. क्या किसान कुछ पीछे आने को तैयार है?
जी बिल्कुल तैयार है. मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि सबसे पहले सरकार MSP को गारंटी कानून बना दे, देश में किसान आयोग का गठन कर दे. ये सरकार के हाथ में, और इससे सरकार का कोई नुकसान भी नहीं होगा, तो मुझे लग रहा है 80% समस्याओं का समाधान हो जाएगा. फिर ये जो भूरा कानून लाए हैं, जिसे काला कानून कहते हैं, इसमें ज्यादा कुछ नहीं रह जाएगा. इसको ये रखें या ना रखें, अगर MSP को गारंटी कानून बना देते हैं और किसान आयोग का गठन कर देते हैं, तो सारी समस्याओं का समाधान हो जाएगा.
Okay, we'll have to wait and see what the government does when they meet the farmers on 15th. They have now a leeway for 2 months, but can the government and also the farmers, because the challenge for the farmers is to sustain their protest, keep it peaceful, and for the government to make sure that there is no untoward incident as far as 26 January is concerned. That, ladies and gentlemen, could change the picture and dynamics completely how we are witnessing this entire movement. Thank you so much, Rahul Srivastav, Master Shivraj and Aparajita Sarangi, for joining me on 6 p.m. Prime. I'm slipping into a very short break for 26 January. Yes, that is going to be the next big day as far as the farmers' protest is concerned. There are preparations going on from both the sides. Tractor rallies are also being prepared, farmers in Punjab and at the borders. On the other hand, the police and the law and order machinery also preparing to deal with any eventuality. That story coming up after a short break. Stay tuned.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.